but the sound was coming out of his phone.
Oh, God.
Gabby, what did you hear?
All right, so I was washing dishes and cleaning up in the kitchen, and he was upstairs.
Okay.
I walked upstairs to use the restroom, and that's when I overheard this man. I mean, I could see he had his earbuds in, but his dumbass didn't realize that the volume was coming from his phone. And this girl said, I'm free Tuesday night and don't work the next morning if you want to come over.
Oh. And don't work the next morning.
She got to wear that as.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So I immediately book it into the room, and he's like clearly replying, but he hears me, you know, and he quickly like shuts off the phone and locks it. I'm like, who the f*** are you talking to?
Oh, so you did ask him about it. Okay.
I did. Real. He's like, I'm not talking to anybody. I was just watching videos on the phone, you know, and we argued back and forth for a few minutes, and I demanded for him to let me see his phone.
Did you find anything?
Well, that's the thing. The audio message expired after 2 minutes.
Oh, so he has an iPhone then?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, girl.
And I know he wouldn't know to save them, you know? He's been super secretive lately. He just keeps sticking to the story, you know, that he was just watching videos on the phone. And I don't buy it, you guys.
Right.
Super sketch.
So you know about these messages. You're convinced that this is another woman. Is there anybody in particular you're suspecting might be cheating on you with?
No. Not that I can think of, no.
Okay.
And let's hope that I don't know who it is.
You got that tone.
And I mean, when that Tuesday came, because I know she was like, I'm free Tuesday night, did he go over?
No, I made sure that he came home like right after work. I made plans that day. As a matter of fact, I had his parents come over for dinner that night.
Oh, you nice with it.
You better work,
you nice with it, Gabby.
Nah, I want to try to trap him, man. But you do you. You trap him this way, I guess.
Let's do the staycation setup. We're going to call your man Ricky up, offer him a free romantic hotel stay. Ask him who he wants to put on that reservation. At that point, Gabby, we should all know if he's seeing someone on the side, okay?
Mm-hmm.
We got that staycation set up happening. I feel bad for this guy, boy. With your morning mess up next. The morning mess in the middle of staycation set up. All right, we spoke to Miss Gabby. Thinks her man is cheating after she walked in on him. He thought he had his AirPods on, talking to somebody on the side. But the sound was coming out of his phone.
Dumb.
No. What an idiot, right?
Gabby, what did you hear coming from the phone?
I overheard a girl saying that she was free on Tuesday night and that she didn't work on Wednesday if she wanted to come over and spend the night.
That alone right there?
Yeah.
I get a phone thrown at you.
But the thing is that when you tried to go through the phone afterwards, the messages had disappeared.
Mm-hmm.
They're voice messages on an iPhone, and that's like what they do. They disappear.
They expire if you don't keep them.
Gabby, you're so gangster. So that Tuesday came, you intentionally made sure that he came home after work by doing what?
Oh, I invited his parents over for dinner.
So wanted to make sure he didn't go out that night, but now you want to catch him live on our show. So what we're going to do is a staycation setup. We're going to call up your man, Ricky. We're going to offer him a free romantic hotel stay. Anisha, you're going to play the front desk clerk and ask that important question.
Who would you like to bring on this free romantic stay?
Hopefully he says your name, Gabby. If not, then we all know he's cheating and the show is yours at that point, okay?
Okay.
Are we ready?
Yes. Yeah.
Hello.
Hello, am I speaking with Ricky?
Yeah, this is Ricky. Who's this?
I hope this isn't a bad time. My name is Jonathan. I'm calling from the Aurora Hotel. I've actually got some really good news. You've been selected as the grand prize winner of our free romantic weekend stay. We're going to put you up in our penthouse suite with the honeymoon package. I was actually just calling to confirm details, but I wanted to congratulate you because you're the winner.
Yeah, I'm not interested in it.
Would it help to know that this is truly free? It is offered to you with no deposits, fees, or taxes. Because we're new, we want you to help us build our presence online with your Google and Yelp reviews. And because of that, we're not going to ask for a credit card unless you decide to get room service. And that's, like, optional.
I mean, if we can do this quick, fine.
I got you. If you give me like 30 seconds of your time, I promise we'll get through this. Now, with this free romantic weekend stay, what we do is we start this off with a welcome note. This goes to your guest of honor. I want to give you the opportunity to personalize it however you'd like it. You know your person better than I do. Is there something special you'd like to put on that note?
I don't know. Something generic, like nice to spend some time with you.
Okay, I have that down. So then, Ricky, my next question for you is, who would you like to bring on this free romantic weekend stay? I need your guest's full name for us to continue.
Her name is Ariana.
Are you kidding me right now?
What?
Hey, Ricky.
Hello?
Sorry to say, you're live on the radio. We legally got to tell you that. We're the morning mess. Your lady Gabby's on the line.
yeah, you're a f***ing piece of shit. You know that, right? Like, I cannot believe that you are inviting some a**hole on a romantic free weekend.
What is happening? Like, what are you doing?
What do you mean, what am I doing? Like, did you forget that I overheard some telling you that he was free on Tuesday night and you could go over a couple weeks back?
You stood around.
Did you think I just so happened invited your parents over for dinner?
You're acting crazy.
And now I had to call the radio station and have them bust you?
Like, you didn't have to do any of this. She's a friend.
Right.
That's not a friend. Mm-mm. So, Ricky, sometimes you got to risk it to get that biscuit.
No.
So who is this girl that you're trying to get that biscuit from?
It's a friend. She's become a friend recently, and that's it.
How long you been hitting that, though?
Nobody's hitting anything. Like, who are you? Gabby, I can't believe you would do this.
You can't believe, I can't believe that I actually believe you when you said that there's nobody else. You know,
there is nobody else. She's just a friend.
Then why didn't you said somebody else?
You would have said Gabby's name.
No, I thought she might like a fun weekend or something.
A fun weekend with you and no clothes?
Yeah, exactly.
Nobody said anything like that. Like, you guys are blowing this
Ricky.
No, she was blown.
Stop it!
He's trying to get her to. Yeah.
So, Gabby, at this point, I do want to make sure you know that there's counseling services that we can offer for you, whether you want it individually or if you want to work on this as a couple.
Yeah, some individual counseling, I think, would help.
No. I want you to pack your shit and get out by the time I get home from work.
Yeah, we'll see.
Get your stuff and get out!
Nobody's getting out of nowhere. Nobody was caught cheating.
Yes, you were. Wow. You literally were just caught.
I don't even know. I'm arguing with like four people. Gabby, if you want to talk about this, let's talk about this off the radio in person. I'm not doing this with a group of people.
No. Because you're going
to
get your
you don't have to talk about this. You're the one that did this.
Okay.
No, you did this.
I'm done. Like,
you can't be done because Gabby's done, aren't you, Gabby?
I'm so
We're all done.
No, we're done.
Okay, we are done. Yeah,
we're done.
You're done.
I'm done. Ricky, you still there?
I am.
Yeah.
All right, just want to make sure so I can hang up on you. Hold on. Miss Gabby.
Yes.
He lying. You know he lying.
I know he's lying, but I really appreciate you guys.
No, absolutely. You got anybody in mind that you might talk to next?
No, dude, that's not the way I operate. When I'm with someone, that's it.
Exactly, girl.
And look where I got you, though. That's what
is not her fault at all.
Y'all never regretted being in a relationship that person did you wrong. I was like, damn, I should have just cheated on them.
No!
I'm going to be good, guys. I'm fine. You know, like, this guy's not going to break me. I'm a strong, independent woman, which is why he's getting out of my house and I'm not getting out of his.
Okay. Absolutely.
Okay, you like tacos?
I love tacos.
You love tacos. A wise man once said, tacos before vatos. Ever heard that?
No.
Tacos before vatos. Say it with me.
Tacos before vatos.
Orale, there you go. Get your girls together, have some tacos, toss back a few cold ones. The hell with these men. And then get together.
Crazy, bro.
I know,
crazy.
Right?
Very. And we're going to get him some counseling services. If you'd like some, you could take some too, girl. All right. Hold on 1 second.
The Morning Mess.